like this one, BA. Tough ones. Guys who will want to fight and get after. Now here's Hardy. Battle on the wing. Pass to Rudy. Shoots over Portis. That's with the rebound.
Hey, sometimes the best looks go to point to point.
Thank you. spot held by Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Those two have thrown their bodies on the glass during this postseason, showing how badly they want to give their teams any edge they can on the boards.
Thank you. Here's Corkman. Two. Three falls. Torres. He's checked in for Lopez. Tap and fall. So it hits both of them.
Free throw shooting is about intent, confidence, and your mental approach. He's locked in from there most every night.
Time Holiday. Pass to Matthews. Beyond the arc. Oh, can't get it. This is his first attempt. Sixers lead.
physical, forceful play. Another thing is they've created lots of second chances at the line, knocking down a high percentage of their free throws tonight.
Boy, for me, it's really been fun watching the evolution of Chris Middleton. The rangy two guard who can really stuff the statue.
Free throws good from Middleton.
And here the second quarter of action. As you said, the 2.5 minutes later.
Get it to.
Middleton.
He's got 5 points now in the quarter. Well, you've got to respect Middleton anywhere on the arc. Tight corners. He's just that deep.
Thank you.
For the Philadelphia 76ers. An insane quarter. No one could stop him. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Thanks. I'm here with head coach Mike Budenholzer. Coach, how would you characterize the intensity level in that first half?
Yeah, no, it's pretty intense. You know, both teams are getting after it defensively. Nothing's going to be easy, so it's the way it's supposed to be.
Hopefully it continues in the second half. Thanks.
Appreciate it, Allie. And we'll be coming right back after this break. Ready for the third quarter.
Greetings, one and all. The postseason drama we love, and no disappointment here, as it's a close game so far for the Philadelphia 76ers.
You look at the play of their bench, this second unit is doing exactly what the coach is looking for. It's a luxury to have this kind of support.
I mean, I know we talk about team depth all the time, but that's been the difference tonight. Taking a look at the situation for the Philadelphia 76ers. They did what they needed to in game one. Got the win, kept home court advantage. Big fella, how important was that?
It's nice, honey, but it means nothing. One loss here and they relinquish home court advantage. Gotta stay hungry.
Yeah, they can't sit back and get comfortable. This is when the adjustments are made. They need to be sharp for this one.
Momentum up for grabs. Thanks, as always, for watching. Let's head back to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the second half.
Second half, here's Mike Budenholzer's foul. So it's the talented Dennis Williams.
But once Giannis gets the ball in the painted area, Antetokounmpo is really almost automatic.
And we just had to see that mobile one drive one more time.
have almost made it look pedestrian. Also, they were ultra consistent from outside, hitting a high percentage of those shots tonight.
And he drops it first.
Rely on players like him to deliver.
subbed in for Maxey. And the Bucks will go for a different look here. Brook Lopez is checked in for Portis. Ibaka comes in for Antetokounmpo. Ingles, he's checked in for Chris Middleton. And it's Connaughton in for Payton.
Somebody that uses his height exceptionally well to get high quality looks.
Thank you.
Is subbed in for Korkmaz. Matthews, he's checked in for the Bucks.
Thank you.
Both shots good from the start.
Yeah.
can win. It's a game we should win. We've matched those guys step for step. From this point forward, let's try to force them to play at our tempo.
Okay, thank you, Allie.
Thank you. Shooting from the right wing, William Calvin. Two shots.
Seconds left in the final quarter.
And now we go to the attention of fans is suddenly looking back.
Booker. So open to that.
Right here, they just need to get some of these out.
No, you need a quick bucket and then a quick foul.
Oh, good from outside. Got his defender off his feet with a pump fake. Put back it down.
That's his third personal foul. Shooting from the left. Runners off of the group carry. Taking two shots.
Shooting two. Lead. An 8-point ball game. Here's Milton. From deep 3-point range. Tucker, no good. And so it's Milwaukee with the W. It might have been just game two of the series, but this one felt like one must win. I just love the fire they played with tonight. It's the Portland's, and they really brought the energy. All right, let's go courtside to Allie LaForce with our player of the game. Allie, it's all yours.
Giannis, an impressive performance. Talk about what this game showed you about your team.
This game was great. I think everybody came out ready. Everybody played great. We were moving the ball and knocking down shots, but most importantly, we were playing great defense. But at the end of the day, it's just a win. We got to build up this. We got to go back to the gym, watch film, and get better.
It's just one piece of a greater goal. That's right. Thanks, Giannis.
Allie, thank you as always. Time for us to say so long. We hope you've enjoyed our coverage during the second round of the NBA Eastern Conference Playoffs. For Clark Kellogg, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson. Now it's time to present our New Balance Player of the Game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.